I regret killing Mr. Ataga, but don't want to die because of that, says Chidima, alleged killer of Super TV CEO. I regret killing Mr. Ataga. I don't know what my future holds, but I don't want to die. Please, I don't want to die because of this case. I have not killed before. Chidima Ojukwu, the alleged killer of Osifo Ataga, chief executive officer of Super TV, says she doesn't want to die over the case. I regret killing Mr. Ataga, and I don't know what my future holds, but I don't want to die. Please, I don't want to die because of this case. I have not killed before, Chidima pleaded. I was just trying to comfort myself to answer questions during the parade, and not that I am not showing remorse. I totally regretted everything I did, and I am sorry, Mr. Ataga's family. I am deeply sorry for what I did. If I had my life back, I wouldn't do anything like that. I am deeply sorry, and I hope you forgive me, the Punch quoted Chidima as saying. Chidima and Ataga had reportedly lodged in a service apartment in the Lekki area of Lagos State, and the corpse of the latter was discovered the next day in the room, and the former fled, thus raising suspicion of her complicity in his death. The police said that they went after her and attacked her down at her father's Alakumeji Yaba residence. Upon her arrest, Chidima attributed her action to the influence of hard drugs and alcohol. Speaking further, the 300 level student of University of Lagos, UNILAG, said her parents separated when she was 2 years old and she started living with her uncle Chijioke Obi in the Mushi area of Lagos State. She added that while growing up, her childhood ambition was to become either a musician or an actress. The suspect stated, my role model was Tiwa Savage, Beyonce, Rihanna, Genevieve, and Regina Hall. I schooled in Johnson Primary School and also a government primary school in Mushi. I later went to Seedman College in Sabo Yaba. I was 2 years old when my parents separated. I was little, so while I was growing up, I stayed with my uncle, Mr. Chijioke Obi, in Mushi. I don't know if he bears Izu, but it was my uncle that trained me. I really feel sorry for this girl, actually. I know that what she did was wrong for killing the man, but she regretted her action, and I wish that the government will temper justice with mercy. That is my opinion and take on this issue of Chidima. I really feel sorry for her, but a crime is a crime, so she needs to pay for her sins. Let's go to the okay. So, as it is now, I don't really know what is going to happen to Chidima, anyways, but I really hope she is tempered with the mercy, or even if she's going to go to jail, let her sentence be with fair, and let them be fair in justice in sending her to jail. But anyways, we'll say that the case, only the judge can judge, and only them knows what is going to happen to Chidima. And I'm not a human rights activist, and I really know nothing about law, but I hope the law takes a course. Let's go to the comment section and hear what people have to say about Chidima. Has this not adequately exposed our hypocrisy as humans? We go to church every Sunday and mosque on Friday, disturbing God and requesting for his endless forgiveness of our sins. Chidima has just asked for forgiveness of men, and everyone is shutting her down and placing curses on her and wishing her to severest of the law penalty. We should be ashamed of ourselves as humans. My own is that how did she stab Uncle severally and she did not sustain any injury? via retaliation or assault, as she claimed. Omo Baba was drunk. Even if she's not giving death sentence, jail term is enough, okay? To me, she has confessed her sins. She should be pardoned. If government can pardon thousands of Boko Harams and bandits, even give them scholarship, then what else are we now talking about? She should be pardoned and rehabilitated, okay? To my own opinion, she deserved pardon. But when judge found her guilty, then I remain mute already. The book have stated what to do. I pity this young lady because of her age and such a sudden death of this guy, which I suggest this may be her first case of killing a human. You killed but don't want to die. It's okay. No be quarrel. Oya, bring him back to life and you are free to go. Case dismissed. But wait a minute, what if this was a script play by Lai Mohammed and Bubu to distract all Nigerians from the fact that country is hard and that 1 euro equal to 702 naira, okay? I saw CCTV camera showing where the two came to the apartment at Lekki, where they enter something before going their room. Why not use the same camera, check what happened before the man's death, but don't show us where they were doing kerewa. I am not supporting the girl, but they should do thorough investigation of this matter. Exactly. Just like what the deceased family said, that there is more to this matter, that so many questions haven't been answered, and yet they don't want anyone disturbing them anymore. That if anyone has any information, that person should go to the police and give their information to the police. And exactly my take, because if this girl truly is as innocent as she's claiming to be, that she was drugged and intoxicated, okay, how was she able to locate where the knife was so easily? And how come she stabbed the man not just one but three times? Because there is so many questions to be answered. And if you and this man have been going out for 4 months like you claim, then this is not the first time you both have been having anything to do with each other. So what brought about the violence to the extent of killing him? Well, the first side chick is the beginning of wisdom. My dear, nobody will kill you. Right now, from the time of Abraham, there has never been a law in our country. Just try and help us kill one more person. Buhari, you are our savior. Eh? This is really, really strange. Now people are asking the girl to go after Buhari, but she hasn't even gotten out of this one yet, and you are trying to push her into killing Buhari. I don't really know if you know what you are saying, but I will only ask for justice, on that justice should take its course, and the judge should temper justice with mercy on the case of Chidima. Thank you for listening. God bless you, and you can go to the comment section and share your take on this issue.